courage is in God, he enables us to overcome anything. You know, throughout my life, I've realized a scheme of the enemy. And I believe it's true in your life as well as it is in mine. There's a certain aspect of our lives that the enemy tends to attack the most. He strategizes and devises a plan, schemes against us to attack us in many areas of our lives, but in one particular area for sure. And we're going to talk about that area. If you're going to be what God has called you to be, you're going to need this. If you're going to do what God has called you to do, you're going to need this. And that is the area of courage. Being courageous for God. I remember when I was about 24 years old, I went to preach in a small church in Brooklyn, New York. It was it had a middle aisle, and there were people that sat on to the right, people that sat on to the left, and there was this middle aisle. I was about 24 years old. This is over 20 years ago. And I remember standing at the pulpit. And when I got to the pulpit, the mother in the church, she wore all white. I was a young girl, you know, she wore all white. When I got to the pulpit, she stood up, took her chair, turned around, and faced the wall the entire time I preached. She stripped me of my courage. It was a form of rejection. And I'll tell you this much, rejection is the root of many things that the enemy will use against us. It's from that area of rejection. This woman don't realize that for over 10 years, that image stayed in my mind. What was the enemy was doing? He was attacking me where I was called. For over 10 years, I would be asked to go preach places and I would say, no, I'm not. No, I'm not feeling well. That would be the excuse that I would use. Or why don't you use so-and-so? Oh, I know of a person that you can use. All because of that image that was seared in my mind that told me, you are not qualified. How dare you? Who called you to do this? And for year after year after year, I would turn things down. I would step to a pulpit. I would step to a pulpit already with defeated thoughts in my mind. Because I felt that this woman, since she was the mother of the church, she was right, and I should not have been there. And then one day, God challenged me. Nadine, but who did I call? I called you by name. And I began to think through all the times that God had called me when I was in prison and I was going through situations and when God had used different people to remind me of who I was and how he called me and the purpose of God on my life. But you know what? Sometimes it's not what other people say about you. Sometimes it's not even what God says about you. It's what you believe about what God says about you. Because God could tell you all day long that you're called. He could tell you all day long that you're purposed. He could tell you all day long that he wants to use you. But until you believe that, that is the time that you start. And the thing is, the enemy is after our belief. He's after our courage in what God said. Isn't that what he did with Eve? Did God truly say? He wants to get you to doubt, to disbelieve, to have unbelief in the area that God has called you.